Kids, welcome back to Kids Church. Recently, we've been recapping from the beginning. Last week, we talked about Adam and Eve and the biggest questions on earth, like...
How on earth did I get here? Remember, God made me and He loves me. Second question is, who on earth am I? God made me and I am His child.
God placed Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden, where they walked and talked with God.
Well, today we're going to be looking at these two big questions.
What on earth went wrong and how do we fix it?
Adam and Eve ate the forbidden fruit and sin entered the world, and that's the answer to what went wrong.
Sometimes things in life can go wrong. Have you had anything in your life go wrong? Well, at Kids Church, there's been some pretty funny things that have gone wrong. Let's check it out.
We always have an idea in our head of what we're going to build. Sometimes we... Sometimes we just change our mind.
Hi, I'm Crystal, and I'm 4 years old, and I'm dressed up as Iron Man.
Hi. What?
Oh!
This is one we prepared earlier, and as you can see, it's squishy, and it bounces when you drop it.
What?
That's why we look in our gardens for the eggs these days.
Oh no! Oh, come back! Come back!
That's why people think that rabbits lay eggs. Come back here.
Yeah.
Okay, what could we do, buddy?
Do the blue cleaning.
No, not the, just say do the cleaning, not the blue cleaning. Just say do the cleaning. What else could we do, buddy? What else could we do, Bo?
Do the blue cleaning.
No. So, Bo, what about you? Have you got any ideas?
No.
You sure?
No.
What about doing the cleaning?
No.
Oh, goodness me. So, buddy, you're just going to say, do the cleaning, okay?
The cleaning.
Okay, one more time.
Do the cleaning.
Bo, have you got any ideas?
No.
No, you just...
This is a little... Oops.
Thanks, Nisha. Okay. Third biggest question. What on earth has gone wrong?
And we're going on a journey. Okay, okay. Well, on day last... Yes, and River's song, she just released an...
No, sorry. Released a new album. Wow.
And how to make sure we don't get into awful times. What's wrong with this world? They're going to help us, aren't you? Oh, that was terrible, you know?
Sorry. Hello, I'm Kevin, and today I will be teaching you how our lives are like our bikes at home. We need to make sure that our bikes are well looked after and maintained so that we can be safe on the road. As we go through life, we tend to sit. Sin sticks to us. Like this bike, the mud and dirt represents sin in our lives. But all we have to do is ask Jesus for forgiveness, and he will wash us clean like this. First, we have to undo the brake. Take it out like this. Now you're gonna grab the new tire and put it in where the old tire was. So slide it in. You're gonna get your tool and make it tight. Lastly, it is important to keep the chain well lubricated to protect it against rust, which can cause it to snap. Just like us, we need to keep ourselves well fed with God's word from the Bible. Alright, now, since the chain has been well lubricated, we're now going to turn the bike over and make sure the brake is tightened, because that's very important when we go riding. Now that your bike is serviced, you can enjoy your trails. My favorite trails to go on is Shakespeare Park. I usually go on it with my dad. You can even try ask your dad to go on your trails with you. I hope this has inspired you and helped you one way or another.
Jesus came to fix what went wrong. And even though life isn't perfect,
because we live on a fallen planet,
if we make the right choices, we can do amazing things.
What we do really does make an impact on our life in this earth. And having a good attitude really helps.
Hey kids, hope you're having fun with Mum and Dad at home. Ace has asked me to share a few basketball tricks with you. Hope you enjoy them. Now, dribbling. Dribbling is really easy and really fun. All you need for dribbling is a ball. Now, for dribbling, you're just gonna use your fingertips and just ride the ball. Don't slap the ball. Okay, now here's a challenge. Try to do 5 on this side, and then 5 on this side. Now, if you're an expert and you really want a challenge, you can go between the legs, like this. Now, say you do have a hoop. You want to have a good distance as well. You can have as much distance as you want, but start up close. And have one foot in front, whatever foot you feel comfortable with. My comfortable one is my right foot, and my left foot is slightly behind. But make sure you're square, your shoulder width apart with your feet, and you're square to the hoop. And do the same thing like I said. L. R. I hope you enjoyed all that basketball. My favorite basketball player is Steph Curry. Apart from all his amazing moves on the basketball court, he also has Philippians 4:13 written on his shoes. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And that's one thing God has taught me through playing basketball. No matter how bad a game I'm having, or no matter how many points my team is losing by, I know I should never give up, because I can do it, and I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And you can too. No matter how bad a school day you're having, or a bad game you're having on the court, it doesn't matter. You can do all things, and God will give you the help. I hope to see you guys playing basketball soon.
God is perfect, and we were created in His image as perfect human beings. Look at this lovely clean water. I could drink it.
But Adam and Eve sinned. Which meant they had to be separated from God. They were no longer perfect. They felt fear, guilt, shame, all because of their sin.
Unfortunately, from then on, what Adam and Eve did affected all of us. The Bible tells us that all of us have sinned. No one is perfect, except Jesus. Maybe we have been disobedient to our parents. Perhaps we've said a lie or taken something that's not our own. Sin separates us from God, which is sad because God loves us so much.
But the good news is God has a plan. He fixed our problem of sin and our separation from God.
He sent Jesus, who is perfect, to die on the cross for our sins. He took the punishment for our sins that we have done and will ever do.
When we ask God to forgive us for all the things we have done wrong, He does, because of Jesus. And His forgiveness changes us. See?
Wow! We are restored to righteousness. This means that we can be friends with God and be close to Him, just like we were created to be.
We can either choose God's way or our way. You have a choice too, but we know you would choose God's way.
That's right. Our big story has now moved on, and we're going to be talking about a man who did make the right choice. He saved the whole of mankind from a massive flood. The second question is, how on earth do we fix it?
Well, this man was called Noah, and God called him to build a huge ark to fit all the animals on. See?
Hey! Noah's family and the animals came aboard the ark two by two.
But what happened to the dinosaurs?
Well, let's recap. A was for astronomy, wasn't it? We talked about how God is an amazing creator. B was belief. Oh, it's so important, belief in science, and we're going to find out about that again when we look at some important things. And C is cause and effect. Now, can I go back? Belief. Some people cannot believe what happened with the ark, but it is totally believable when we see how God made that humongous boat. Surely we could fit all the different kinds of animals in there. And do you know, we've got D is for dinosaurs. We have found there are actually fossils throughout the whole world. And would you believe, they say, it's amazing. They look like they didn't really decay. They look like they died all of a sudden. I wonder what could have happened. Maybe a flood. And they say they're kind of covered in soot. Well, do you know, to have all of that water coming out from the ground, and all of that craziness happening, there was probably volcanoes erupting. And so it all actually makes a lot of sense if you believe in Jesus and God and the Bible. It's amazing. Well, getting back to dinosaurs, I've got a few friends who love dinosaurs. So we're going to cross over to them and see what they have to tell us about these amazing animals.
Hello, my name is Tamsin and I love dinosaurs. I love dinosaurs because they're my best friends. My favourite dinosaur is a pterodactyl because it flies high in the sky. Some dinosaurs are tall like the Brachiosaurus, and others are big and scary like T-Rex. I'll give some dinosaur facts. Dinosaurs that eat plants are called herbivores. Dinosaurs that eat meat are called carnivores. One of my favourite things to do is play dinosaurs with Daddy. It is so much fun. Thank you for visiting me and my dinosaurs. Bye!
No! No! You move it! Oh! No! It is not a bad dream! This is not like the cruise ship I was expecting!
Well, what were you expecting?
I don't know, like a buffet, a pool, fruit basket, live bands, water slide.
Whoa. We're escaping the flood, not going on holiday. I'm pretty sure Noah's priority wasn't making sure we had a tennis court on board. I, for one, am very happy to be safe and not out there.
Yes, but I am King Julian, and I've grown accustomed to it. Like, shake it, move it, life.
Julian!
How can I be happy while stuck in here? I mean, it is a big boat, but 111, 112, 113 days. I tell you, I am starting to feel.
Julian, I think you have the case of the smalls.
The what?
Well, the smalls. It means you lose all perspective and, well, your world gets kind of small.
But I'm not small, I'm big!
Our world becomes small when we think only of ourselves, Julian. Miss Piggy always told me that sometimes in life things aren't the greatest, and we could look at the situation and think, this is not what I wanted, or even, it stinks right now. But when we look at the big picture, we know and trust that God loves us so much, and He protects us. There is nothing that happens in our lives that He doesn't know about.
Well, I guess I did make it onto the ark safe and sound.
Yes, and just before God shut the door too. Such a blessing. We were meant to be on this ark, Julian.
Well, I guess if you put it that way.
And best of all, God promises that He will never flood the earth and told us by creating a beautiful rainbow. Look, see.
Whoa! It is amazing!
Why are there so many songs about rainbows?
Mm-hmm.
And what's on the other side?
Oh, they're so pretty!
Someday we'll find it.
What?
The rainbow connection.
You mean God?
The lovers, the dreamers.
And me!
Yes, and you, Julian.
I guess you put it this way, it's not so bad.
It sure isn't.
Wow, kids, wasn't that awesome? Being reminded of how Noah was saved in the ark. Do you know that that ark actually reminds us of Jesus and how Jesus saves us? We look around the world and we think, what's wrong with this world and how do we fix it? Well, we actually can't fix it, can we? Only Jesus can. I don't know if you're feeling a little bit worried or fearful, or you've got things on your mind that you are really battling with. Do you know that Jesus can help you? All you need to do is to ask Jesus. Say, dear Lord Jesus, I want you to come into my life. Please help me. I've got these things that are weighing me down. Forgive me of my sins and all of these worries. I give them to you. Come into my life and forgive me of my sins. I want to live for you. Do you know Jesus just comes straight into your life and He will bring you a peace that you will never, never totally understand. And as you start getting to know Jesus, all you need to do is just talk to Him like He's your friend. Talk to Him about your life and He is so there and He is listening to you. You can read the Bible and this will help you learn more about God. And then another great way to build your faith is to find a good church, other people that believe in Jesus, and you can encourage one another. Well, we love you kids, and it's been awesome being with you today. And we pray you have an awesome week, and we'll see you next week. Bye.
Hi kids! Welcome to Super Scriptures with Sade
and Fun Facts with Fran. I'm Sade
and I'm Fran,
and together we're the Bible Twins! Today we're going to talk about how the Bible is like water, and we're going to be talking about Noah. It's definitely a lot of water in that story. Cheers to that.
Cheers
to Fun
that.
Facts, Fran. Actually, before we start, I have a little bit of a joke for us.
Oh, I'm ready. I love a joke. I love facts, but I love a joke.
Do you need a boat?
Why?
Because I know a guy.
Oh, ba-dum-ts.
Anyway, fun facts, Fran.
Yeah?
What does water do?
Well, Super Scripture Shade, I'm glad you asked. Water cleanses us, refreshes us, helps our entire bodies function, and carries nutrients around our bodies.
Mm.
And it is really, really good for us.
Wow.
If we don't have water, we get
smelly,
tired, and even sick.
Ooh, into the elbow, please.
I did sneeze into
good
the
job,
elbow.
Good job.
This is why, as Christians, we need to have our spiritual water, the Word of God, because it does all of those things for us.
Yes. A great scripture I found is in John 4, verse 13. Jesus answered, "Everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again, but whoever drinks the water that I give them will never thirst. Indeed, the water I give them will become like a spring of water, welling up into eternal life." So what that shows us is that Jesus will come and live in our hearts and help us. But when we're reading his word, it helps refresh us, it helps cleanse us, and it helps our entire body work just as normal water does, but it helps us spiritually, which is fun, isn't it?
That is amazing, Super Scripture Shade.
Yeah.
Well, let's hand over to Talia for a fabulous craft.
Bye, kids!
Hi, everyone. My name is Talia, and I'm going to teach you how to make chalk paint so you can paint outside and brighten up your driveway. Here's what you are going to need. Corn flour, water, food colouring, a tablespoon measurement, something to mix it with, I have a teaspoon, a muffin tray or some plastic cups to mix everything in, and last but not least, some paint brushes to paint outside with. Let's get started. For each colour you want to make, you're going to need 2 tablespoons of corn flour. So, 1, 2, 1, 2. Now for each of your colours, you're going to need 2 tablespoons of warm water. So the corn flour and water are equal parts. So let's get our first one. That's 1. And that's 2. 1, 2. Now the fun part, add 2 or 3 drops of colour into each of your paints. I have these colours at home, but you can use whatever colours you want and have. So first I'm going to add green. And that was 2. And blue next. And I'm going to add red and blue to make purple in this last one. Whoa. Now we mix it all in. So first I'm going to mix this one. and that's it. Now let's go paint outside and see how it looks.
Right, time to have some fun and paint. You can paint whatever you like, and when it dries, it'll look just like chalk.
I think the first thing I'm gonna paint is I'm gonna paint a heart.
Have fun painting. Bye.